Hi everyone, this is Prashad Parthiban. Today I'm going to take a training on workers' compensation insurance. And this is going to be my part 2 video. If someone is interested in my part 1, where I have covered about the purpose of workers' compensation insurance and what are the benefits we get from workers' comp and who is covered as part of workers' comp, please go through my YouTube link that I have given in the description of this video. And let's start with this today's session. Today, I'm going to cover two things. One is the structure of the policy, workers' compensation policy. The second one is how the premium is calculated for workers' compensation policy. These two are very important for us to understand the workers' comp at a high level. To start with the structure, this is the structure that you will see in your contract document. Starting with the information page, it goes on until the endorsement. So information page is nothing but it's going to have the basic details about the insured as well as the insurance company, like the policy number, the insured name, agency or the insurance name, mailing address, and when the policy is going to be effective and when the policy is going to expire and the limits and the states covered. All those informations will be documented under the information page. General section, again, it's going to have the basic information about the workers' compensation law and some of the critical definitions of terms like we and you. When we say we, it's nothing but the insurance company. When you say you, it's nothing but the insured. And all other details will be there in the general information. Similarly, we have a part 1, workers' compensation insurance, which is the core coverage that we give to the insured. So under this workers' compensation insurance, any loss that is covered as part of the workers' compensation statute or law will be covered under part 1. If there are scenarios that are not covered under the workers' compensation law or statute, that will be covered under employer's liability insurance. One good example, if I have an employee who got injured during the work and they will be covered under workers' compensation insurance. Similarly, the same employee got injured due to a faulty machine and the employee sued a vendor who developed this faulty machine. In turn, the vendor sues the employer back saying that the machine was not well maintained. So those scenarios will not be covered under law. So this kind of scenarios will be covered under employer's liability insurance. The other core difference is there is no limit as such. Any coverage covered as per the law will give the required payments by the insurance company. But when it comes to liability, there are set limits that the insurance company will pay. Anything after that limit will not be paid by the insurance company. Also, there are no specific exclusions documented under workers' compensation. Anything that is covered under law will be covered. But when it comes to employer's liability, we do have some set of exclusions that are not covered by employer's liability insurance. The third category is other state insurance. Again, say if I have an employer who is having business in California, tomorrow he wants to expand it to Texas. So the Texas has to be documented in this part 3. And once he starts the business in Texas, he has first 30 days full coverage. And within 30 days, he has to notify the insurance company to move the state from part 3 to part 1 of information page. Part 4 is nothing but your duties if the injury occurs. If some loss happens, it's very important that insured has to notify the insurance company promptly. So all those duties will be documented here. Part 5 is nothing but the premium, like how the premium is calculated. All the required details will be documented here. Part 6 is conditions, like what are the different conditions? Like say, if you want to cancel the policy, only the primary named insured can cancel, or if insurance company can always do some kind of inspection, all those details will be documented here. Endorsement. So apart from the basic policy, if the insured wants to add some additional coverages, they can always do it through the endorsements. So if you open this policy form, you'll see whatever the sections that you just know we discussed will be here. Part 1 is nothing but workers' compensation. And then part 2 will be employer's liability. It goes on like that. This is how the structure looks like when it comes to workers' comp. This is the second part that we want to discuss today, which is a very important part. How do you calculate the premium, which is very important, right? Like, when you take homeowners, we know how do we calculate, like based on the dwelling amount or the experience and the amount of years the dwelling was there. So when you take personal auto, we know you take the driver's history or the car's condition into account. Similarly, when you take workers' comp, there are two things that we have to take into account. One is a classification, and another one is a premium base. When you say premium base, it's nothing but the payroll. If I have an employer where I have 50 employees under the employer, under out of the 50, there are 35 employees who, say if you take a software company, who are software engineers, there are 10 employees who are doing clerical job. There are 5 employees who are doing some other set of jobs, right? So we classify the employees based on their work category and then give them something like class code. So for each class code, we give the corresponding rate, base rate, based on the loss history and based on their complexity. So once you have the class code and we know what is the overall payroll we pay them for on a yearly basis, we use these two criteria, class code and the payroll, and then we use a base rate that we know for each class code and then come up with a premium. If you see this example, we have the class code for this policy, we have the overall payroll, so we have the base rate for each of this class code. So the way we do is, for workers' compensation, always the premium is calculated $100 per $100 payroll. So in this case, what happens is the overall payroll is $20,000. So we divide the 20,000 by 100 and then multiply by the rate, which will give the overall premium for this class code. Similarly, we document all the class codes and come up with the corresponding premium, which will give us the overall base premium. On top of it, we have to apply all these, you know, factors. Like in this case, I have taken experience mod as one of the factor, and then we'll go in detail about experience mod. And then when you apply all the factors, we get the overall finalized premium. So we discussed about class code. We discussed about payroll. What is audit? In workers' comp, we know if I issue a policy today, the employees may have a payroll of $20,000, but within 2 months, the employees could get promoted and the payroll could go to $30,000. So once the policy is expired, the insurance company does some kind of audit where they come in person and understand overall actual payroll, and then they will come up with the updated premium. Based on that, if the premium is more, the insurance company is going to send the invoice to customer. If the payroll is less, the premium insurance company is going to give back the credit to the insured. Experience rating, again, based on the last 3 years, the loss of the insured, this experience rating could differ. If the insured does not have major loss, the experience rating could be less than one. If the insured had major loss, the experience rating could be more than one. Based on that, the premium could differ. This example, if you see, the employer had an experience rating of 1.25, which increased their premium. Whereas the employer had other safety features, like maybe a premium discount and all those stuff, which brought the premium from 1045 to 888.25. Retrospective rating is nothing but if, say, I have a policy for 1 year, during that 1 year, if there are not major losses, at the end of the term, you do some kind of retrospective rating to understand the losses. If during that 1 year, if there are no major losses, we give back the credit. If during that 1 year, if there are major losses, we get more premium from the insured. Premium discount. As we all know, the administration cost is not going to go up based on the premium. So if there are customers with more premium, the insurance company can always give more discounts. So that's what we use this premium discount for. Schedule rating. If I have an employer who has all the safety precautions taken into account, so we give some kind of credit. Like say, if I have an employer who have regular training set up for the employees so that they maintain their environment clean. So those kind of environmental related safety precautions will give some kind of credit to the insured. Rate deviations, every employee or every insurance company will have some kind of rate deviation up to 5% or 10% so that they can attract more customers. Expense constant. This is a flat amount that every insurance company they charge to the insured for the issuance charges or no any administrative charges. Deductible plan. Sometimes it is possible that the insurance company or the insureds can say, let me pay more deductible. Deductible is nothing but in case of claim, the insured has to pay the deductible first and then the insurance company will pay the payments. So if they select higher deductible like $2,000 or $3,000, the premium will be low. If they select lower deductible like $500 or $200, the premium will be high. Dividend plan. There are some insurance companies, they give dividends like at the end of the term, they give flat of 5% or 3% back to the customers on the overall premium. So that's what the dividend plan. If you are on the dividend plan, you get some kind of credits. So pretty much this is how the premium is calculated. The core thing that we have to keep in mind is the class code and the payroll. And then once you have that information, you can come up with the premium by this formula. You will always take the class code and then use that rate of that class code and then multiply that by the overall payroll divided by 100, which will give you the overall premium for that class code. And then we document all the required class code for the employer and come up with the overall premium. Once you come up with the overall premium, you apply all these discounts or no factors into account, which will come up with the overall final premium. I hope you like this video. Please do subscribe to my YouTube channel if you like this video. I will continue posting a lot of training videos on the property and casualty insurance and Agile. Take care. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.